the one B is.
One is this.
The fourth one is this. Well, B is not in common.
Much.
No,
much
a B.
A B.
Yeah.
You remember me?
Yeah.
You remember me?
Yeah, I remember you. Blockchain.
Go back.
No.
Back.
First
line.
The prime intent of our project is to make a chatbot using recommendation, and it is to run our by making interface for recommending products to the users. First of all, we start e-commerce and it's there. In today's trends, these all services are running in retail background, faster shipping and better logistics, data integration and AI machine learning, voice search everywhere, etc. I recommend that chatbot. Chatbot interact with user and understand its need using. And we use dialogue flow for creating chatbot and input, and we take input for our chatbot and understand the need of the user and recommendation using recommendation system at the backend, and we suggest him product for our or need their need. This is the Accenture company's report, survey report of the Accenture company, and they say 56% of recommendation they recognize them by name, and 58% their recommendation option is the based on past purchases. 58% in that survey. And 55% purchase history from they know, and 75% from above 3 offers. And we expect fully played chatbot for our recommendation engine. These tools and technology we have used Python, and Python is for and up on the
tools and technology are used in our project is Python, Anaconda, set of Flask, Dialogflow, flow and ng-doc.
What is ng-doc?
Ng-doc.
It's provide a public URL for connecting a dialogue flow and our Python function running.
So basically, it creates a tunnel to our server, so like to our machine.
A provider tunnel, see. Dialogue flow is owned by Google. It is a human computer interaction technology. Which is used natural language for conversation. It will make our dialogue flow intelligent. Dialogue flow provides some basic features like default response, create an intent, and in intent we create means train our data and train up based on train our response. Advantages means it works with array of platforms. Means it work with Facebook, means we launch our chatbot to Facebook, Hangout, Skype, Google Assistant. It also provides a cross support, cross device support, means we use in a phone, a smartwatch, cars. Also, it supports 14 plus languages. How means our.
You mean the chatbot you built, it will support 14 languages?
Yeah.
Dialogflow supports 14 languages, how
Dialogflow is work basically. When we go into chatbot, if we write hi, then it call a default intent. And in go into response part, if we write the text area on that, it randomly choose any of this response and display into chatbot. Create custom question and custom
this
response.
This is your application, right?
Yeah.
This chatbot is your application. The one that you built?
This is a Dialogflow.
From where did you take this snippet?
We have three intent based product, friend product and similar product. In with that, we write a question related to means user put into a chatbot, and we define one action. That action are called in a means called to Python function, and their machine learning file is there. They give a response and display to a chatbot. NgLock is a lightweight tool. It provides a secure tunnel between our local server to a public URL. Means when we pass some input, how intent call a particular Python function. When user enter any text into any platform, these texts are go to Dialogflow. Dialogflow call a particular agent. Agent fetch a keyword and pass to particular intent. Intent call Webhook function. There is a one problem. Webhook function in Dialogflow and Python function in our machine. So we use ngRock for that. So we first run our Python function in particular port. That port are providing to ngRock. ngRock give a public URL. That public URL are put into fulfillment, and then Dialogflow and our local server are connected. And then Python function give a response, and then they are redirect to a Dialogflow. This is a Dialogflow. Google Assistant is connected with the Google Assistant.
So considering it as a research project, I researched into a lot of things like what type of recommendation systems work nowadays, and I researched about many of this is a basic project plan we followed. Till April we have deployed the chatbot on Telegram and Facebook and Google Assistant also. Should I show the data exploration I did? Is it okay?
Not in detail, but you can describe it.
Thank you. can see the data exploration in the report also. It shows the basic number of transactions we put up. So this is the count of transactions, views, a particular product viewed how many times, a particular product was added, how many times added to cart and transacted. So this amount was really less, I plotted it again. This is the number of added to cart count and this is the transacted, well, bought products. So this was a particular data given by IBM itself. So the data was really, there were like 96% were view events and there were like 2.5% of add to cart events and the rest were transacted. And these are the top 5 products all over the data set and these are the top 5 users all over the data set. You can see the data set is really fully hashed. We don't have the names, we just have the IDs. So as suggested by the Anshuman sir, I found out few data sets and I mapped map those IDs to those products. I found like product list of Amazon and then I found a name list. So I named I mapped the user IDs to those names. So it made it user friendly. These two were the external data sets I use in my product. Then in basic recommendation systems. In traditional systems, we use top performing, the most performed best products we suggest to the buyer. Or the content best method means if a person likes bread, then he would surely buy butter. Then collaborative feature means if a person is buying bread and a person is athlete and other person who is a swimmer, is a type another type of athlete, so we will suggest same product to those similar type of athlete. So this
data you have it?
Yeah. No. This is I'm explaining where I'm coming to.
Okay.
These were the traditional methods. Then I researched more about the recent methods. I came across Light FM and ALS. Light FM is like the most fastest right now recommendation system engine in Python. It creates a user and item interaction matrix and using that matrix, it recommends the products. It doesn't only consider user or item, it considers both. Interaction of both of them.
Give you an example
what it is. I'll come to it next.
Okay.
So this is a content-based metric where user and item. For a particular U1, these are the products and I will recommend those products which are similar. If a user one bought this item 1-to-1, if you bought, we will write it 1. And if you find a similar user, which is U2, which has a similar profile like U1, then we will suggest him to buy this product, item 1. This is the collaborative similarity matrix in which we map user to user, like U1. U1 to U2 is 0.3, so there is a less recommendation chances. If U1 is buying some product, then there is a less chance that U2 will buy the same product.
Can you go back to the previous
slide? Yes.
Right. You are going to explain about the light FM, right?
Yeah.
You will explain.
Yeah, right.
Nice. Okay. Yes. And ALS also.
Yes.
These two methods, these are traditional methods, you explored this.
Okay. Yeah, then these are the recent methods, next. Then this is ALS. ALS is like, if we have a user to item interaction data, like the main purpose was like for those type of data which don't have ratings or likes or comments. Like if you go on IMDb, you will find ratings, you will find comments. So you can give a score to that particular product.
But in e-commerce, we don't have that score all the time. If you want to launch a new product, then we don't know those how will the product perform in the market, and how should we recommend to those particular, how should we focus on particular group, those will perfectly, well, those will certainly buy the product. So that's why this is a user to item interaction metrics, in which we have the interaction between user and the item. And ALS is nothing but it factorizes the matrix. This is the user matrix, then this is the item matrix. It gives a score of each particular user and a particular item. Next. So PUI, the previous matrix I showed, it shows the preference of a particular product. Then for a particular product, we use the confidence, like for a view and for a bought product. People say that we should give a confidence 10 times higher than a view product. If I buy a product and I view a product, then if I am recommending to other person, then I should give 10% more pressure on the bought product than the viewed product. So we can give the confidence in our whatever way we want using this alpha value. This is the research paper I studied in. They have given this loss function to train the model. Yes. From those trained model, X is the user, X matrix is the user matrix, and Y is the item matrix. From by differentiating those cost function, I get to that these two equations. Then at the end, to find the score, if I need to find a similar item, I use this function. If I need to find a similar user, I use this equation.
So you are explaining this for ALS or which one?
This is ALS.
Or for ALS, all the slides.
Yes. Next. So this is light FM. The formula of light FM. Light FM is really simple. We have a user features. Light FM uses a lot of. There are many variants in the light FM also. How to generate these user features? I didn't get into depth of that because I had to cover a whole project. So using the equations, I understood that representation of user I item, and we have used the bias terms also, and we find a recommendation for a particular U and I for a particular user and item. If I need to find a recommendation score, it will give a score for each item. So I use this formula. These are the advantages of light FM. It does a lot of different loss functions. ALS is joined to one loss function only. We have three different variants in loss function in light FM. The Bayesian personalized ranking, weighted approximate, rank pairwise, and K was one. Should I get into that?
So things you tried, you were telling, right?
Yeah.
You're telling me a lot of things. I'm trying to understand, where you tried what. That thing is not there. Okay, this is for light FM you are telling.
Right? Yeah.
ALS you used. Yeah. Right? The traditional approaches you tried, but that didn't fit him or didn't fit or
didn't
you
fit
want
into
to
our data set because the data set was really.
Okay. And so which one you have used? ALS?
I have used both into the. Okay. Consideration. I have given three options as Janvi told. The best product all over the website. For that I have used Light FM. Then to recommend from a friend, I have used ALS for that. And to find a similar friend, similar product for a particular product, if you need to find a similar product, for that I have used Light FM.
Okay.
Next. This is the basic flow of working. You will get the idea here. Greeting starts, I ask for user ID, we ask for user ID, then it goes to similar user. There are three options. You want to find a similar user, or you want to find a similar product, or you want to find, that similar user is like the product those
users
have.
Whatever you have bought,
that
is also the same, right?
Yeah. Then this is friend request, like similar users. If you need to find those both athletes are same, if you need to find a similar similar product which this guy bought.
So, but you have those information, you train data, like let's say two are athletes, you are telling. Data you have, the
main thing of LightMM is it automatically generates the user and item features. That was the main point in LightMM.
That's what it does.
It generates it from the interaction.
Items the users purchase, it predicts this could be an athlete or somebody like
it. It generates the metrics from the data we have, like for this person viewed this person viewed bought this person identified this. From the whole data set, it automatically creates user and item metrics, LightMM. So if you want to find a similar product, then we ask for product ID, or else we recommend directly the recommendations, products.
First of all, Chatbot asks for user, and then we log into Chatbot, and after that, the screen will be displayed. We